this race has been a real journey of personal development. I think we're probably all richer for the experience.
It has matured me as a sailor, I think, in a way.
There's moments where everything goes well and everyone's quite happy, but there's tough moments that you have to go through.
I find that fascinating, to be living for 9 months in a world that is so competitive. And this is what you live and breathe for. So great results, you're happy. Bad results, life's miserable. You know that sometimes you have to invest a couple of days losing to get a gain 2 days from now. But the toughness of this race is that all these teams have the same ambitions, but only one of them are going to fulfill it.
You hear the guys talking about tenths of a knot. Throughout, from the start of the time we started testing a year ago, right through to now, having accurate sensors and accurately calibrated sensors is critical to any decisions we make on board. And when you're racing side by side against another boat and you're looking for tenths of a knot, it's really important that you can tell and just get those gains.
We rely heavily on the electronics of the boat, mainly for performance, to see how we're going and how fast we're going. We rely on it, especially at night, and in the recent days with the foggy conditions where you can't see anything, you have no bearing on where you are. So you really rely on the numbers to tell you how you're going and keep you in check and keep you on course. So certainly is an important part of our sailing.
You know, when you're driving at 35, 40 knots of wind, and it's the middle of the night, and or you're in thick fog and you can't see past the bow of the boat, you know, you've got to rely on the instruments. They are your lifeline. That's what keeps you going fast. That's what keeps you going in the right direction.
12 minutes out from turning up, okay?
We've had one of the most challenging, windiest, toughest conditions in the Volvo throughout the whole race, actually, that certainly I've ever seen in the five editions that I've sailed in the race. It's been incredible that we've had zero issues with the BNG system on board. It's always been rock steady, reliable.
BNG takes care of all the data that is related to the boat. So meaning the speed of the boat, the position of the boat, the temperature around the boat, the heights of the waves, the heel angle of the boat, the pitch, the roll, the wind speeds, the wind directions. All this information is collected with BNG sensors through the BNG network into a BNG processor. And from there it's streamed as telemetry data through the satellite system back to race control. So race control has BNG data from all these seven boats every 10 seconds.
Data's critical. Unless all that stuff is calibrated perfectly, you really can't say what winds you're sailing in. And the kit is reliable. We've got great new displays on the boat, the H5000 displays, and we've had no problems at all with those this whole lap of the planet that we've just done.
The BNG instruments have been very reliable throughout the race. WTP hasn't missed a beat. Performance is superb, but also all the displays connected with it and constantly being hosed with water, smashed by waves on deck. Amazing how well this electronic equipment lasts in those conditions.
Where we've got to as a fleet and how competitive we are, it's been an incredibly challenging race. It's been a real physical and mental test. It's incredible to see how hard we managed to push these boats, and it just goes to show, you know, how competitive the race is, how hard people are pushing, and you know, and the lengths you've got to go to win in this race now.
After the race, you go through this phase of happiness or disappointment at the finish line, and then you get some distance to it, and then you start to recognize and appreciate more, regardless of the result, what you actually went through. And you realize that, you know, yes, you have these amazing moments that you do love, you know, midnight sailing, full moon, 40 knots of wind, big waves, stars. I mean, it's insane, the experience. And you start to recognize that when you have some distance to it. And then you appreciate it, and then you want to do it again.